In this video, I'm going to show you how to use green screening to create videos with your students. Done right, green screening is an excellent opportunity for students to collaborate and work together on a complex, engaging project-based assignment. My name is Sam Kary, and this is my YouTube channel for the new EdTech classroom. As you can imagine, doing a green screen video with your students does require a little bit more equipment, planning, and setup. Pre-planning with a green screen project is essential and will make or break whether or not your students are successful. The first important thing that you need to do a green screen project is a green screen. I have a pop-up green screen that also has a floor cover. I've also tried putting up green fabric, and I know teachers also sometimes just use green paint on a wall. I've tried different things with trial and error, but I found that by far the best thing to do is to set up my green screen in the classroom, and when we're ready to film, I just have a screening party and we film our takes. If you have the space, you could of course have students film in another room. It is important that it's relatively quiet while students are filming so that all that other noise doesn't get into their videos. As you can see, I also have lights and a microphone, though neither of those are necessary, and I've made green screen videos without both of them. The next vital piece of a green screen project with students is that you are adequately preparing them. A poorly planned video is not going to go very well. So I always have students work in groups on a planning document prior to film. As you can see on this document, I have students decide some skills that they are good at and who has those skills as a way to make sure that everybody feels valued in the group. I have students choose different group roles that they will be taking on during the course of the project. Then I have students plan for the main purpose of their video or skit. They pre-plan the characters they are going to create, who that character is, what that character's traits are. Then students plan the setting so they can think about the different types of backgrounds and possibly props that they would want to bring. It's really important that you have them plan out the different scenes, what will be in that scene, what kinds of props or other materials will they need to set that scene up. Then I have students work on a script, which I have them mostly memorize if possible because it makes for a much better video. And lastly, students plan if they're going to bring or make props, other visual aids, or costumes. I've seen not so great videos and amazing videos, and I can tell you that the major difference is how prepared students are when they're actually ready to film. Next, I'm going to show you the software that I teach students to use called WeVideo. I use WeVideo because we have Chromebooks, and other green screening apps like DoInk are only available for Android devices or iOS. But those would be a great option as well. Okay, so let's look at how we would actually create a video project. I'm going to go up to blank edit, and now that I'm in my video editor, you'll see that WeVideo is basically a layering system that allows you to bring in different videos, audio, images, etc. I'm going to walk you through how I taught my students to create their videos, which we did for an Egypt social class skit. The first thing students will need to do is go to the folder with the star on it. They will click on the red record button. Here, students will be given an option for how they want to record. Now, in this case, because I'm using a computer, I have access to a webcam. Filming with a webcam is okay. I have to admit that it would be better if you had tablets to film. And what I actually have done sometimes in my own class is use my own tablet, and then I share that media with my students. It's not the most ideal option, but it works. Okay, so now let's say that I just filmed some footage through my webcam, or maybe I created it on a tablet. Students will then see the media that they just filmed in their My Media folder. The first thing that you'll need to do is instruct your students to drag your video down into one of the layers. I have them drag it into a top layer because if they're going to bring in a background image or video, that's going to need to go on the bottom layer. Okay, so let's say that a student sees that they have some footage that they want to cut. The first thing that they can do is drag to the place they want to cut, click the scissor, you'll see that I now have two separate video clips that I can move around. I'm going to actually go to the first one, hit the trash can, and it's gone. Okay, so let's now look at how I can use the chroma key to remove the green background so that I can put in a different background behind it. I'm going to double click on the clip. I'm going to click on the dropper, click where you see green on the screen, and you'll see that it gets rid of it. Now, you'll notice that there's a little bit of green seeping around the edges. So one of the ways that you can fix that is by sliding around the defringe. It looks like I'm able to get rid of some of that green seeping by sliding around the defringe. Now, the next thing that I'm going to need to get rid of is that picture of the light on the side. If this happens, you need to go up to the Transform tab, click Transform. If you zoom in a little bit, you can cut that out and you can still move the image around where you need it. Okay, so now I'm ready to put a different background into my movie. I'm gonna click Save Changes. I'm gonna go to the Star tab and I'm now going to search for an image that I want in the background. Now I knew from my planner that I wanted a picture of the Giza pyramids. So I'm gonna check it out and see if there are any images of the Giza pyramid. If I wanna make sure that I'm filtering for images only, I'm gonna make sure that I click the images. And there I see that I actually don't really have any good pictures of the Giza pyramids to be able to put in my background. There are some videos, but that's not what I want right now. So I direct students to go to other third-party websites. A good one is Unsplash. Unsplash is a great place to get pictures where you can feel safe about not violating any copyright. Here you can download a picture and then upload it into your WeVideo so that you can use it as a background. I'm gonna grab this picture. I'll go up to the green import media cloud, click browse to select, find my picture. Once my picture pops up, I can drag it down into my video editor. And there you'll see that my image is superimposed over the Giza pyramid. Pretty cool. If I need to drag the clip so that it covers the entire distance of the video that I created, I can just simply click the edge of it and drag it over so that now my green screen video is overlaid onto the pyramid. The next thing I'm going to show you is how to use some of the transitions and other features like audio and text in WeVideo that will really improve the quality of your students' video production. So the first thing that I will do is grab both clips and make a little bit of space in front of my video. I do that by hitting Shift on both clips and dragging them forward. And here I'm going to look for the different media they have for Egypt, but this time I'm going to look for videos. So here we'll see that there are lots of different videos that I can add. I'm going to grab this animated growing ancient Egypt, drag it down. Now this video does not have sound, so if I want to add some background audio, I can search for audio. Here I see there's a track called The Sun King of Egypt. So I'm going to drag that down into the audio clip. I'll shorten it so it's just the duration of the intro, and now you'll see that I have a cool little video with some audio in the background. Awesome. Okay, so now the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to add a scene transition rather than just jumping right into the footage. So the way that I'm going to do that is by going up to the text tab. I'll look for a motion text. I'll try one of these out, like layer cake, drop it into the studio. When I double click on that text, I'm going to see that I'm allowed to edit the text. So I'm going to change that to something like Egypt skits, scene one at Giza pyramid. I'll click save changes. And now I'm going to bring those two clips that I made earlier back over so that all of the clips play in unison. The next thing I'm going to show you is how you can teach students to add a cool transition to start their scene. So here I'm going to go up to the transitions tab. I'm gonna find a transition like curtains. I'll drag that curtain transition down right in front of the first scene. Okay, so now I've added my own video footage that I chroma keyed out. I put a Giza pyramid background behind it. I also added a short video introduction as well as some audio to play behind it. And then I put a transition right before my scene. So let's see how that turned out. Thank you. There are a couple things that I need to fix up, but for the most part, it makes a pretty awesome video. Once students are done, they're going to click the finish video, and students will actually have fewer options than the options that are given to me here as the administrator. What I like to have students do is connect their Google Drive, since I use Google Classroom. So they'll click on the Google Drive icon, click export. After they've exported their file into Google Drive, they can easily upload it into Google Classroom to share with other students. Green screen videos are a great way to get students to collaborate on a fun, engaging, and complex task. In addition to learning how to work together and to plan a skit, they'll also learn some really cool video editing techniques. If you have any questions about how I've used green screening with my students, please ask in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you found it helpful, please hit the like button. And if you'd like to see more of my education technology tutorials, check out those other videos and subscribe to my channel. Thanks and have a great week.